Minister, I want to raise the issue of North Wicklow Educate Together School, which is based in Bray. It's a voluntary secondary school under the patronage of Educate Together, and that patronage was awarded in 2015. Now, the school is currently in temporary accommodation in Bray. It's the old Presentation College School in Bray. And that lease is due to expire on the 30th of April next year. Now, the Minister and the Department last year made an announcement that arrangements had been put in place. They had identified a site in Bray Town Centre, and that announcement was made last June. Now, since that time, very little information, in fact, no information has come from the Department. Educate Together, North Wicklow Educate Together, are completely in the dark. Now, there have been some concerns raised with regard to the site that had been identified. It's on the site of Bray Institute of Further Education, which is in the town centre. And that site is controlled by Kildare Wicklow Educate EETB. Now, there have been some controversies regarding the ex-CEO of the ETB, and currently those are being investigated. And unfortunately, it appears now that North Wicklow Educate Together are some way being implicated and held up in those investigations. Now, we have an impending crisis looming here. Currently, there are 200 students in that school, which certainly could not be described as being fit for purpose. They started enrolling last year, September 2016. They now have 2 years in place. They're now due to enrol another year come September. So there will be 200 pupils in that premises come this September. But come April next year, the lease, which is held privately, is up on that building. Now, the school, the principal, the parents, the future parents and students in that school do not know where they are going to be come April next year. Now, numerous approaches have been made to the Minister, by myself, and indeed other Wicklow TDs. The five Wicklow TDs sent a joint letter to the Minister. I've spoken to the Minister on numerous occasions, and no information has been forthcoming with regard to the site that has been identified. As I said, some concern has been raised by Bray Institute of Further Education. They feel that they had not been consulted in the process in regard to the identification of that school. So we are now caught in a vacuum. But in that vacuum, it's not being held by the no information, the lack of information coming from the Minister, who has ultimate responsibility, no information coming from the Department. In fact, North Wicklow Educate Together met with officials from the Department last week on foot of a meeting that had taken place the day previously with representatives, I think the new CEO of the KWETB. No information was given to the school in question here, Educate Together, as to what was discussed with the CEO of the KWETB. So we have a school, a principal, 200 pupils, their parents, not knowing where they are going to be come April next year. So it's unfortunate the Minister isn't here to deliver some sort of clarity, some sort of time frame as to what the parents, what the school can expect, and when they can actually get onto their site, into their new school, wherever and whenever that may be. And hopefully, Minister, you might be able to outline some of those time frames and give some clear information.
4 minutes, Minister.
Thank you, Laskin Corla, and thank you, Deputy Brady. I'm taking this matter on behalf of Minister Bruton, who is not available owing to the fact that he's in the Education Committee taking the admissions bill. Thank the Deputy for raising the matter, and it provides me with an opportunity to clarify the current position in relation to the accommodation needs of North Wicklow Educate Together post-primary school. As the Deputy is aware, a major capital project for the provision of permanent accommodation for North Wicklow Educate Together to cater for a long-term projected enrolment of 1,000 pupils is being addressed through the Department's six-year construction programme. The Department's capital programme continues to address the challenge posed by a rapidly increasing school population, including in areas such as County Wicklow. In addition to major school projects, the capital programme also provides for devolved funding for additional classrooms for schools where an immediate enrolment need has been identified or where an additional teacher has been appointed. The Action Plan for Education sets out the Government's ambitions for the education system, including the commitment contained in the Programme for Government towards the prioritisation of school educational infrastructure. Following the capital review, additional capital funding of €332 million will be available to the school sector, primarily from 2019 onwards, boosting investment in our primary and post-primary school infrastructure. This significant investment reflects the priority which Government has put on education on delivering on our ambition to deliver a fair society and a strong economy. It is planned that in the period to 2021, over 350 announced large-scale projects, including a major project for North Wicklow Educate Together, will be advanced under the Department's construction programme. An option for the location of a permanent site for North Wicklow Educate Together post-primary is being finalised. North Wicklow Educate Together post-primary school was established in 2016, and as an interim measure, with the assistance of the ETB in Kildare and Wicklow, the school was housed in a property leased by that ETB at Putland Road in Bray, the old presentation building that the Deputy mentioned. The school opened with an enrolment of 36 pupils, and numbers are growing incrementally with an enrolment of 119 pupils in 2017. The Department is aware that the existing lease on the Putland Road building is due to expire in May of 2019. Officials from the Department have been and are continuing to liaise with Kildare and Wicklow ETB in relation to ensuring that North Wicklow Educate Together has adequate accommodation to cater for their growing pupil numbers from September 2019 onwards. I want to clarify for the Deputy that the Department is continuing to prioritise this matter and will be liaising with the patron of the North Wicklow Educate Together when a further update is available. As I said earlier, the Department is liaising with the ETB in Kildare and Wicklow in the context of a permanent school building for North Wicklow Educate Together, and will also be liaising further with the Educate Together patron in this regard. Once again, thank the Deputy for giving me the opportunity to outline the position to the House, and I wish to assure him that the Department is concerned to ensure that both the interim and long-term accommodations needs of North Wicklow Educate Together post-primary school will be provided for.
2 minutes, Deputy Brady.
Minister, I thank you for the response, and certainly I'm not going to shoot the Minister or the person who delivered it, but there's absolutely no clarity in that whatsoever. None whatsoever. We're facing a crisis here. Come April next year, there will be up to 200 children with no premises to be educated from. A site has been identified in Bray. There are questions there. I'm not sure how long that process, I'm not sure what is actually happening to that, and that is key. There's one line here, an option for the location of a permanent site for North Wicklow Educate Together post-primary school is being finalised. An announcement was made last year that a site had been identified, so as far as the school are concerned, who aren't under the patronage of KWETB, who seem to have more information than Educate Together, which is bizarre to say the least. So information is key, but also key here is the school is well aware that there will need to be some sort of temporary accommodation until the new school is constructed. They are very, very conscious and very, very aware of that, but they don't want to have to move into temporary accommodation on a site somewhere in North Wicklow, where we don't know, because there has been an exhaustive process carried out where three sites were initially identified. Two of those were quickly ruled out as being totally inaccessible at this point in time, leaving the one site that we're talking about here. So the school is conscious that there will need to be some interim arrangements, and what they want to see happen in those interim arrangements are the possibility of prefabs going on to their permanent site wherever that will be come April next year. So there needs to be some sort of prefabs or temporary accommodation provided on the site where they are ultimately going to finish up with their purpose-built school. What we need are clear timeframes, and that's what's lacking in this nonsensical statement, which is very, very disappointing. The schools need answers, not the KWTB. They don't hold the patronage. It's the Educate Together. The principal in the school needs these answers. I need these answers. The pupils and the people in North Wicklow need these answers.
Minister,
and hopefully,
respond over your time. Minister.
Okay. Yeah, just to reiterate what I said to the deputy, that the minister in his response outlined that he will be liaising with the patron of North Wicklow Educate Together when a further update is available. The issue about and the line about being finalised, I don't have specific timeframes. I haven't been given them. But the matter is a priority for government, and nobody wants to see a situation where there's an already active school that won't have accommodation. I don't think that there's any prospect that you've suggested that 200 students are going to be homeless next May. But it's about providing the short-term measure until the new school is built, and providing a permanent home thereafter. And the Minister has been clear in his words here that he's given to me that he will be liaising with the patron of North Wicklow Educate Together to that effect.